again, as Bruce alluded to before, I think Conrad Bocanegra is definitely a guy that has to be a major target on this play.
Number four for the United States. Lennon sends it in, the header, and that's into the back of the net! The United States strikes, and it's Jimmy Conrad! Jimmy Conrad finds the net! 1-0 USA! Jimmy Conrad, a late bloomer, he'll be 30 next Monday. A big goal in his career.
Well, I mean, you have such a game, a defensive game, the kind that he's had already tonight. But he didn't even have to jump for this. This ball was perfect for him. He was able to snap that in the corner as well.
Hey!
It's the very curious news from around the globe with the amazing Connor Dean. Very curious news item number two. I'm finally chiming in on the Christian Pulisic situation at Chelsea. You know the part where American fans in particular are upset because he's not playing much with the Blues, but I believe there are a couple of issues at play here. One, he got signed under one manager, Maurizio Sarri, but he left, and now Chelsea have a new one in Frank Lampard, so the plans for Pulisic's role within the team could have changed. Two, though with number one being said, I remember Sarri being somewhat surprised that they signed Pulisic, and it didn't seem like he really knew much about him, which proves the point I made in a video a while back about this purely being a marketing move. Because Pulisic is arguably the best player on the US men's national team, and he's a Nike athlete, and Chelsea's a Nike team, so Nike probably paid for some of his transfer fee since it would expand Chelsea's reach and sell a lot of Chelsea Nike kits in the biggest market in the world. But the American fans are becoming more savvy, and they're not just gonna buy his jersey unless he actually plays. And he did, for a little bit, to start the season, but since then, the English manager is using his very talented English players in the starting 11 like Mason Mount, or more experienced players like Willian and Pedro instead, which might feel unfair at times since Pulisic has made a difference when he comes onto the field, but let me tell you how you fight unfairness. Play better. Every single day, in training, in games, it doesn't matter, play better. And this goes for everyone who is a player right now, not just Pulisic. If you want to get into the starting 11, play better than everyone else on the team. And when you're not in the starting 11, which is going to give you the impulse to complain or have shitty body language, which makes it clear that you're unhappy, shut your mouth, stop feeling sorry for yourself, be a good professional, and then when your opportunity comes, play better. Because no one owes you anything. Frank Lampard doesn't owe Christian Pulisic a thing. If Christian Pulisic was undeniably the better player at every training and in every game, he would be playing. It's that simple. If some days he's good and some days he's not, and it feels even between him and his competition, then that gives the manager, Frank Lampard in this case, a chance to go with his favorites. And after the year that Frank Lampard spent with Mason Mount last season with Derby, of course Mason Mount is gonna be Frank Lampard's favorite. He knows him. He trusts him. Frankly, I love that Pulisic is going through this because it's gonna make him tougher. And that mental strength is gonna serve him well both on and off the field throughout his career. But now he just has to figure out how to play better, consistently. Very curious news item.